Okay, we're going to look at your project summary. But before we do, we need to make an announcement. Mr. Banning sent me an email. You'll see the links underneath this lecture on the main page for today, on today's topic. Your homework there. Part of your homework is to go and do the graduation related links. There are a couple of forms that you need to fill out. Get those forms completed and print copies of both of those before you submit them to Mr. Banning. Well, print them, submit them, and then get the copy of the print to Mr. Banning before the due date that is noted on the website. All right, so now on to the project summary. This is an actual bona fide designated official section of your paper. It's going to be in the table of contents, so there will be a project summary heading. This is going to be your reader's first interaction with your project. This is going to be their introduction to the project. It's also going to be what gets approved by the faculty member. We'll talk about that a little bit later. So here we have the official desired outcome for your project summary from your official guidelines. The summary is an informative abstract of the proposal that briefly outlines the most important points. It may contain a brief description of the problem. Well, let me just say it's going to contain a brief description of the problem. It's going to have your proposed solution and the benefit. Of course, you'll also need to play the devil's advocate a little bit in there and make sure that you've seen all the conflicting viewpoints. We'll talk about that a little bit later. But we want to really convince the reader that your project has value. You kind of want to sell it, okay? We need to see, why is this important? Why would we invest so much trouble in doing this thing, okay? Tell us what's great about it. Let me just say, from our perspective, what's good, what makes a good project is how well does it integrate the coursework? And I'll probably mention that several times, but show us what you learned. Demonstrate what it is that you learned from your time here. All right, so what we're going to see in here is a description of the problem, proposed solution, and the benefit. There again, tell us why this is so valuable. How are you going to demonstrate what you learned? What's it worth to other people? Now, when you get done with this little bit of your document, just this project summary, this is what you're going to be taking to a faculty member, and they're going to be signing off on a little form that I will get to you. Don't look for faculty approval yet. Don't try to get somebody to sign off on it. You can start to kind of get some feedback from a faculty member. Don't expect them to give you a project, okay? Don't just ask for a project. This is something that you should be coming up with on your own. We want you to think about this, okay? There are rare circumstances where a faculty member may have a project that they want to put somebody on, but just come up with something on your own. Start out. Also, if you have a project, don't just ask a faculty member, how am I going to do that? You know, think through it yourself first. Try to have a plan in place and then get feedback on the plan, not so much asking, you know, how do I do that? That's a very little value in industry, is to be a person who doesn't really know how to think through a project. How are you going to accomplish something? All right, so here's what we need for this thing to be successful. Your summary. This says executive summary, but this refers to your overall summary. Your overall summary needs to be clear and concise. Don't try to just burn out 300 words, okay? We want to have some meaning here, okay? It needs to be clear. We should be able to understand what it is that you're saying, and it should be to the point. Furthermore, keep in mind that who are the different people who are reading this have no idea they have no idea at all what your project is about. They have no idea what the context is. They have no idea of all this stuff. You know, you live with it. You're breathing and living this project of yours day and night. And it's real easy to just assume everybody else knows about your project. Well, we don't. Okay, so make sure that it makes sense and provide us with some context there. Think about what the faculty member is going to ask you when they read through this proposal or through this summary. Okay. And anticipate the kind of questions that they're going to ask. Like I said, play the devil's advocate. Take an opposing viewpoint. Tell us, think to yourself, what might somebody say is weak in this project? Anticipate that they're going to find that weakness and head them off at the pass, okay? And then as you develop your summary, questions are going to be raised. Try to anticipate and answer those questions. All right, this is, you've seen this before, okay, in different classes. This is a good lens to put on top of your project, on your actual writing of your project, as well as the project itself, okay. Number one is clarity, and that one is first not only because it's on the list first, but it's also first in importance, okay. A lot of times we'll have a senior project that we're reading the report on, and it's, you have sentences in there sometimes that just don't have any meaning at all. Make sure that you read this thing out loud to yourself, or have, better yet, have somebody else read it to you. Should be precise, accurate, depth, you know, go into a sufficient amount of depth, go into a sufficient amount of breadth. What have other people done that's related to this project? How is it different from other projects? Logic, the parts should all make sense together, and it should be objective, okay? Don't just be self-serving here. Think about, what are the opposing viewpoints? What are some of the arguments that are going to be brought to say that maybe this is not such a great project? Think about those things, and if they have good arguments, you know, maybe it's time to move on and do something different. Let go of that project. Is it relevant? Okay. If your project is about, you find yourself in medieval literature really deep, it may not be the most relevant thing to engineering technology. So make sure that it's relevant to what we're doing and what we're about here. It should have some intellectual merit, okay? As we say, no Mickey Mouse projects, okay? Make sure that you have something that's worthwhile. Is this something that some eighth grade school group has done in the past? Probably not going to fly, okay? Make sure that you're stretching your mental capacity here. Broader impact, this is real good. If you can figure out some way that your project is going to make people's lives better, that's a good one. A lot of times I like to suggest that we have projects for developing assisted living type things, or some kind of assistive devices that help people to live better lives. A lot of times you'll maybe find contests out there that you can enter your project into. That's been a recommendation of mine for a long time, that you find some of these design contests and things, find those and enter them. That'll, a lot of times, just reading the rules for some of those contests will help you to see what the broader impact of maybe your project could be. And then integration, and I mean this in two ways in this particular context. Integrating the different parts of your paper are important, but also your project should integrate different parts of your coursework. So, especially your upper division coursework. I'll break it down a little bit. Okay. So, the gold standard of what makes a good project, think about your upper division coursework. How well does this project display all of the skills and techniques that you learned in your upper division coursework? How well does this show those things off? And that's what makes a good project. Putting together a solar-powered car kit is not going to fly, okay? So if this is some kind of a kit and you assemble the kit, never in a million years is that going to pass, okay? So don't just think if you put a Heath kit together or something like that that's going to work. not an existing project. Don't just go out to Hackaday and knock off something that's already out there. That's probably not going to fly either. Okay, now you can leverage something that's out there and make it better. But don't just, you know, don't just go out and knock off something that's already been done. Not necessarily a product, okay? Keep this in mind. There are a lot of really good projects that are not products. There are a lot of quality improvement, process improvement projects that people have done in the past that have been really good. They don't necessarily have to be a product that you've, you know, designed, developed, and prototyped. All right, if you do a product type project, better mousetrap kind of thing, you need to approach it not as a single thing that you can make. Okay, this is a trap a lot of times that people fall into. If I cut and weld this machine to this other machine, that will make a new product, and that'll be great. Not so much. Okay, that's not what we're looking. We're not looking to see that you have good cutting and welding skills here. Okay, we're looking to see that you can design a product and get it to the point where it could go to market. Okay, that means that you have planned. You've planned your space requirements, your equipment requirements, your material needs. You've sourced the material. Okay, you've got a prototype that has not only been built, but a prototype that has been tested and evaluated. Okay, so we want to take it beyond just kind of proof of concept or prototype stage. We want to show that you've got a notebook and a working model that's something that you could take to like a venture capitalist, and they would say, "This is great. I will fund you, and we'll start this thing off." Heck, maybe you want to go out to Kickstarter and actually get your project kickstarted and start it up. Okay, we want to take it to that level. We don't want to just kind of have, I think this is going to work. It's not just a mock-up, all right? And like I said before, the gold standard is integrating your upper division coursework. We don't want to see that you can just do some cutting, do some welding, do some soldering, that you can stick a couple of resistors into an Arduino or some LEDs. We need to see that those other skills that get developed at your upper division coursework level. So that's your 3,000 and your 4,000 level courses. More than proof of concept. Now, don't wait till the last minute, okay? Or you're gonna flunk out in a big way. You should be working on your project already. You should kind of have this going. Finish your prototype stage early. So in part of your plan, have like halfway through the project, you should be at the prototype stage, and you should be testing it and evaluating it, making improvements and refining your design. Let me stress here. Design is about iterations. Your design is going to go through multiple iterations before it is finished. That means you're going to make a draft copy of this like you do your paper. You're going to have a draft. And just in the same way that writing is about rewriting, hopefully you've heard that before, in the same way, design is about iterating your design. It's going to change as it gets developed. All right. If you want a quick start guide, here you go. Here's what we need. And of course, don't just turn in this. You know better than that. When I say fill in the blanks, I mean with your project summary, these are the things that we should be seeing. I should be able to read through there. This is a solution. This is my solution. It's my Arduino-powered rocket ship, okay? The problem is that, you know, I can't get to the moon, whatever it is. Fill in the blanks with your summary, keeping in mind that we don't understand, we don't know the context, we're not in the industry that you are thinking of, okay? Give us the context around your project. Tell us why it's important. And also, your project, believe it or not, is going to be similar to some other things that have been done. I promise you this, okay? There is probably out there a patent on something extremely similar to what it is that you're wanting to do. Tell us how it's different from those things. And in order to tell us how it's different from those things, you're going to have to go out there and find out what those things are. I guarantee you, no matter how novel your product is or your project is, something has been done in the past that's similar to it. Tell us what those are. Tell us why it's different from those things. Okay. And then, of course, this is that same thing I've been talking about, that gold standard of the senior project. Here's how it applies what I learned from Tech 40 whatever whatever, from Tech 30 whatever, 40, okay? Tell us how it applies what you learned in your upper division coursework, and we will be ever so happy, okay? So check on the page where you found this video about the homework that's going to be due. I should, at this point, if you're watching this, okay, I should have right now your executive summary. You gave it to me in the form of a memo, all right? This particular document, your project summary, which is unpacking that executive summary, that's going to be in the format of your actual paper. So go ahead and get the template and start putting in your writing. The words executive and summary should not appear anywhere in what you turn in to me from this. It will have what the paragraph that was your executive summary, it will have that in there. It will have that paragraph, but it won't be titled executive summary. This is your project summary, okay? Just the first paragraph of your project summary is your executive summary. But if I see those words executive and or summary, well, okay, I'll see summary. But if I see executive and summary together, getting the big red marker out, and I'm gonna swipe it. All right. Other than that, stop by or email if you got any questions, and we will move on from there. So I'll see you next time. Have a good one.